Dragons. Today is Thursday. It is September 9th. It is the 26th day of school, and we're so glad you're here. I'm Mr. Butcher, and it's my job to keep you guys safe so that you guys can show us how excellent you can be. We hope that you left your average on the bus or in the car, and you're ready for to have a respectful and responsible day. Speaking of responsible, our first responsibility we have each day is to be ready to show respect for our rights that we have in this country and at our school. Well, we do this by daily saying the Pledge to the Flag, along with our school pledge and doing our moment of silence. When we do this, we want you to stand up tall, put your hand over your hearts like this, say the pledge loudly, clearly, and with pride. Don't worry if you don't know it yet. Keep listening. Keep trying your best. I went into 2 kindergarten classes yesterday, and they were awesome at it. So we can do this. Just keep working on it, and we'll get it in no time. Leading us in the pledge today is Ms. Caldwell and Mr. Vu.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America, and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Please remain standing for the Kennedy School Pledge.
I pledge myself as a Kennedy Dragon to be ready for the day ahead of me. I will be respectful of myself, my teachers, and all others I meet throughout the day. I promise to be responsible for myself, my actions, and my learning. I will work my hardest to be the best dragon I can be.
Please take a moment to reflect silently on our day, our activities, and what we hope to accomplish. Another responsibility that we have in our school is to help each other stay safe. One way we can do that is by slowing down the spread of germs, and we can do that by washing our hands frequently. When we wash our hands, we want to make sure we're using soap and water or an alcohol-based hand sanitizer. Look, I got a new jar. Yes, this is the green stuff. Stinks, but it's good. Alcohol-based. When you wash your hands, you want to make sure that you're washing for at least 20 seconds, getting all parts of your hands. I washed Miss Creech's class do it yesterday. You guys are awesome at it. So let's model what good hand washing looks like. Get yourself some hand sanitizer. I got good ones now. And let's go. We want to get the palms of our hands. 2, 3, 4, 5. Get the backs of our hands. 2, 3, 4, 5. Get the back of the other hand. 2, 3, 4, 5. Yesterday when I was doing this with Miss Creech's class, one of the students had a donut in his hand and he was pretending his donut was soap. Wasn't too good for the donut. 4, 5. Make sure you get your fingertips. 2, 3, 4, 5. Get the other fingertips. 2, 3, 4. It's real important to get that as well as ground as 5. And then get your thumb. 2, 3, 4, 5. Your other thumb. 2, 3, 4, 5. And then your wrist. 2, 3, 4, 5. And other wrist. 2, 3, 4, 5. Wash with soap and water or hand sanitizer, not donuts. Clean. And now that we have done our hand washing, we've done our pledges, our moment of silence, let's go ahead and show respect to those that have birthdays today. Happy birthday to Cohen Suter, who's 9 years old. Happy birthday to Juliana Menard, who's 8, and Katie Gonzalez, who is also 8. We'll make sure that you guys get your birthday ribbon. Another responsibility we have is to make our lunch choice. For lunch today, spaghetti with meat sauce, you'll get garlic breadstick, those are really good. Garden salad, peas and carrots, not one of my favorite, I don't like when the peas touch the carrots or the carrots touch the peas. And pineapple tidbits. If you don't want spaghetti with meat sauce and garlic bread, you can always get yogurt and muffin or peanut butter and jelly. One of our big goals this year is to increase our vocabulary. We are doing that through reading, and we're also doing it daily through pictures where you guys can come up with words that you see in the pictures, things that you can talk about. This has also been a great idea to help us improve our writing as well. I didn't even think about that, but it's improving our writing as well. Here's our picture for the week. One of my favorite ones so far. Yesterday was verbs, those action words. What do you see people doing? We had Miss Ham, Miss Jackson, Mr. McCoy, Miss Ballard, Miss Shaw all participated. We saw verbs like sitting, watching, talking. We saw waving, cheering, announcing, and leading. We saw that as well, smiling and judging. Miss Ham had the sentence, one day on college game day, some commentators were talking about the Ohio State football game. A man put on a Bucky costume, just the head, and he looked at it. Silly, just like a coconut. There you go. All right. So today we're looking for adjectives. The adjectives and adverbs, those are the words that describe. Those are the ones that give more detail. What kind of, how were they speaking? Were they speaking loudly? How were they looking? Were they looking intently? How? What color were their shirts? What color were their, how many of them were there? Those are the ones that give descriptive words. Adjectives and adverbs. Come up with some good ones. Make your sentences even better. All right, morning message today is on positive thinking. Here's a good vocabulary word, optimism. A college professor studied 101 people with stressful jobs and discovered that pessimists, people who look at life in a negative way, deal with problems by simply complaining. They don't take actions that will help solve the problem. On the other hand, optimists, good vocabulary word, people who view life in a positive way, deal with problems in helpful ways like making an extra effort, getting organized, or getting help. The professor believes that positive thinking, or being optimistic, can help relieve stress. So, are you really feeling stressed about something today? Think about this and ask yourself, am I being a pessimist, person that looks at things in a negative way, and just complaining and not doing anything about the problem? If the answer is yes, try being more positive. Try being an optimist. Look for a solution. Talk to a trusted adult. Get busy doing something about your problem other than complaining about it, and maybe some of that stress will just disappear. With something to think about, I'm Mr. Butcher. Make today your masterpiece, or not. Remember, choice is yours. And that's so true. Optimist. Look on the positive side instead of the negative side. You know, sometimes there's people complain about things that they can't even control. Listen, I can't control COVID. I wish I could make COVID go away, but I can't. So I got to think about how I can handle things. I wish that we could sleep all day and that there was no such thing as speed limits, but I can't control that. So it doesn't do me any good to complain about it. Let's see about how we can fix it and how we can go on and be more positive about it. You know what? Be positive. Have a great day. All right, we're still under our temporary mask mandate, which means we need to be wearing our mask the right way. So when we put our mask on, make sure it's covering your nose. Make sure it's covering your mouth. Make sure you're not touching it. That's where it gets all gross. And then the more germs on there. So keep it, your hands off of it. Make sure you keep your hands clean. You guys have a great day. That is all we have for announcements. So please help me.
Me and your teachers keep you safe. That is our job.
And your job is to help us keep you safe.
And you can help us by being a ready, respectful, and responsible student who is focused on graduating in the year.
Because when you are a ready, respectful, and responsible student focused on graduation, you are fully committed
to student success.
I love you very much. Have a great day. Remember, we do our read aloud of the day for several reasons. One, to build vocabulary. Best way, vocabulary is just words, knowing a lot of words. We want to know as many words as we can. And guess what? Books are full of words, and this is a great way to build our vocabulary. Two, to model what good readers do. Good readers read fluently. It means they read the words correctly at a good pace. Not too fast, not too slow, and with expression. And when they make the mistakes, they fix them. And the third thing, so that we can practice what good readers do when they're listening through this thing. Think about the story elements. Who, the character, who or what the story is about. The setting, where and when the story is taking place. The sequence of events, what happens first, next, last. Think about the problems and the solutions. And think about these juicy details that helped shape the story. So here's our story today. We will rock our classmates. Written by Ryan T. Higgins. I think he's the same person that wrote, "We don't eat our classmates." We will rock our classmates by Ryan T. Higgins. Penelope was the only T-Rex in her school. Sometimes that made her stand out a little. Look inside here. And sometimes Penelope's classmates didn't see her at all. They just saw a dinosaur. Want to play cops and dinosaurs? You can be the dinosaur. Well, I was hoping to play dentist. Great. We'll be the dentist. You'll be the dinosaur. Have you been flossing? William Amato's backpack is stuck in your teeth. Dinosaur or not, Penelope loved to play. She loved to read. Good night, Tasty Moose, all wrapped in bologna. Good night, Tasty Goose, with a side of pony. Ponies. And she loved to draw. Wait, I won't eat you. I don't even have any mustard. Everyone's scared of Penelope. But the one thing Penelope loved to do more than anything else was to make music. She loved to sing. She loved to play the guitar. Penelope loved to rock and roll. So when Mrs. Noodleman told the class about the school talent show, Penelope was excited. She was also nervous. She wanted to rock her classmates, but could she do it? Also, the sign-up sheet was right next to Walter, the ferocious goldfish. Penelope took a deep breath. She had to do it. She tiptoed past Walter, then she quickly wrote her name with her bravest purple marker. Penelope, rock and roll. After school, Penelope shared the big news with her parents. And I'm going to wear a pink tutu and big boots, spike my scales, and look angry, but I'll actually be really happy. And oh, it's going to be so great. She hummed her favorite songs while brushing her teeth. She danced all the way to the bus. She even told her classmates about her favorite band, the Weevils. Best band ever. My dad used to go to all their concerts until he accidentally ate the drummer. Dinosaurs. At last, it was time for rehearsal. Can dinosaurs even play guitars? On stage, Penelope froze. She could not sing. She could not play guitar. She worried that dinosaurs could not rock and roll. Penelope was very quiet on the ride home. She hardly ate anything for supper. Are you sure you don't want any more, Penny Pie? You've only had 52 burgers. The next day at recess, Penelope sat all alone on the bench. She would not play hopscotch. I'm a T-Rex, not a hopscotcher. She would not play duck, duck, goose. I'm not a duck or another duck or a goose. I'm a dinosaur. At the end of the day, Penelope crossed her name off the sign-up sheet with her saddest blue marker. When Penelope got home, she went straight to her room. Daddy Rex came in to talk to her. Is everything okay? He asked. I can't be in the talent show, she cried. I'm just a dinosaur. Ah, oh, I see, said Daddy Rex. Come with me. Take a look at this family photo album. This is your Uncle Frank. He was a figure skater. Oh, and here's your mom finishing her first marathon. And here's me, the world hamburger eating champion. I ate 5,053 hamburgers with ketchup. You see, said Daddy Rex, being a T-Rex is only part of who you are. You, for instance, are kind and caring, creative and adventurous, and you can be anything you want to be. The next day at school, Penelope marched back over to the sign-up sheet. She looked straight at Walter and almost lost her nerve. Penelope's classmates had a different idea. Can we play with you? In your band? Please, Penelope? And that gave her just enough courage. On the night of the show, Penelope was really excited and also really nervous. She peeked out from backstage to try and find her parents. Not hard to find them. They're the biggest ones in there. When the curtains opened, William Amato and his amazing animal sounds took stage. Chirp, roar, ow, tweet, tweet, honk, aroo. Mabel Hastings and her dancing pony went second. Dip, dap, 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 dap. Then there were the Stegman brothers, synchronized swimming mimes act, followed by Martinez Cortez and her dazzling card tricks. Your card was a 10 of hearts. No. Was it the elephant of spades? Finally, it was Penelope's turn. The lights on the stage were bright, but not as bright as Penelope. We are Penelope and the Mustard Seeds. Penelope was a T-Rex. She was also kind and caring and creative and adventurous. Most of all, Penelope Rex was a rock star. Penelope and the Mustard Seeds came in second place, just behind Mabel Hastings and her dancing pony. That was okay with Penelope. She loved ponies. Ponies. We Will Rock Our Classmates by Ryan T. Higgins.